Welcome back, RPA Champions. In today's video, I'm going to be showing you how to put agents inside of your RPA automations. If you're not familiar with RPA and what I'm talking about, just watch and see what I'm going to show you. So what we're going to be doing right here, we're going to be calling a Microsoft Power Automate Desktop Flow, which is a tool that can automate pretty much anything that we do on our computer. It simulates our mouse clicks, our mouse movements, our keyboard, and so on. So I have built a very simple automation right here that is going to contact an agent that is going to search a web and prepare a report for me. So let's say I was a marketing company and I wanted to send a custom email that where I analyze their company and I provide them a custom SEO report. I wanted to do it for each one of them without moving a finger. So this is how I would do it. I would send and build a automation in Microsoft Power Automate Desktop, all of the manual and repetitive things, such as sending the email, preparing the content, and so forth, while I would use a agent that is built on Flowise to do the AI stuff. So what do we have right here? So right here we have a report that is being displayed in a message for me about Toolei. It is custom, it has done a web search on this solution and has identified all kinds of different things that I'm not going to read right now, but this could be a report put inside of an email and sent to a customer from a list. And that's what I would use Microsoft Power Automate Desktop for. While Flowise, this is the other component of this solution. This is a LLM library built on top of LangChain. So this is a graphical user interface built on top of this library that's built in Python that is used for building large or building complex LLM applications with different kinds of functionality. And it is surprisingly very, very easy to use, and any business user without any coding knowledge can now build some really complex and really interesting automations. To set up Flowise, it is also very easy. I do have a video down below on how to set it up where I go into detail on also some use cases to get you going on Flowise. But right here, I'm just going to show you how to connect it to Microsoft Power Automate Desktop. Now, once you create an agent, and what I have here is I created an agent that is going to search the web, and then it is going to use OpenAI, and it is going to provide me a reply with that. I'm going to select the model of GPT-4. It is going to take my query from Microsoft Power Automate Desktop, and it's going to run it inside of this bot and provide me an answer. There is a lot of fine tuning and configuration that you can do, but I will leave that in a more descriptive video where I go into detail on how to set up these automations. For those that know how to use these tools, this is pretty straightforward. So these are some additional parameters that you can also add, and you can fine-tune this to your liking. It is pretty straightforward to use. But once you have set up your Flowise agent, you're going to go to deploy right here. After that, you are going to go to curl right here, and you're going to get this link over here. After that, you're going to also get this. But let me show you what you're going to use this for. So that was our agent in Flowise. Now, in Microsoft Power Automate Desktop, the only thing actually that we need to do is we need to invoke a web service. We need to invoke a web service with that link that we have seen just now, post application JSON. We can leave the custom headers blank. And inside of the request body, we're going to have a question with the user input. What is the user input? The user input is just something that comes up inside of this input dialog that the user sees in the beginning. And this is a default value that I have added inside, so I don't have to type it in every time for testing. Once we get a response, the response is something that looks like a JSON. So we're going to convert this to custom object, so because it's a JSON. And after that, we will be able to access it just like this. JSON as custom object text and get the result back. Now, this result we can put inside of an email, inside of a post, inside of an application, or anywhere that it has to go. In addition to this, we can see inside of the user input, inside of the JSON as custom object, once it has been converted, it has been converted into a custom object. And if we go inside of the tool, we can see the message response from the text. Let's give this one more try and let's change maybe the link. Let's go with www deeplearning.ai, and let's see what happens with this. So inside of Flowise also, once we are running Flowise, we can see the log inside of our terminal. So to start Flowise, it is very easy. Once you have installed, you just type in npx flowise start. That is going to get that page that you saw started. And in here we can see the log, what is happening, all of the functions that are being called, and we can configure this as well. However, to go back to our message, so this is the deep learning AI analysis. I could send them an email as well. I could obviously fine-tune my prompt much more to make this a little bit better. And in addition to this, what I can also do is on Flowise, I can create some pretty complex automations, such as having prompt chains, using different tools, different kinds of models, using retrieval from my custom documents, and much more. We are going to see all of this and more in my future videos. Don't forget to subscribe if you haven't done so already. It is not going to be a bad click from your side. Why? Because you're not going to be missing out on automation videos that are clear, comprehensive, and that also get the job done. Leave me your comments down below. I really want to check out what you are talking about. Also, I have left some surprise links down below if I haven't said that already. So do remember to check the description and check out those links. Thank you so much for watching, and I will see you in the next automation video, RPA Champion.